Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over the sequence function inside of Microsoft Excel. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So here I have a spreadsheet where I've just entered in a list of possible pets. And I would like to number these pets and give them each an ID. So I think the way most people are familiar with an Excel is if I go 1, 2, 3, and I can start numbering down my column manually like that. But let's say I have like 30 things on here. Some people know that you can click and drag. But if you notice what I just did, if I hit Control Z, I went to my number one only, and I clicked and dragged. And sometimes you get in that situation where it's just copying the same exact number. So if I hit Control Z, and I highlight 1 and 2, and drag, then my numbering is correct because I have selected what my pattern of numbering is going to be before dragging it all the way down. Now that's good if you remember to select the first 2 cells instead of the first 1 cell. But it can be something that's easily forgotten and it can be something that's really frustrating. And if you have a really long list, sometimes you're dragging for a really long time. And then once I have my numbered list, when I've clicked and dragged, if I go down here and I'm like, I hate snakes, I don't even want them in my pet list, and I right click and I go to delete, my numbering is now off because it's not calculated as a formula. Same thing if I were to go up here and insert, and let's say a lot of people were arguing with me saying, no, snakes really are a pet, and I put that back in here, then I can see that a number is not being added here, and now everything's out of order, and I have to resort, and it becomes kind of a pain. So I would like to show you a better way to add an automatic ID. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So let's highlight these and delete them. And then I'm going to click in cell A2 and I'm going to type equals and I'm going to type the word sequence, S-E-Q-U-E-N-C-E, with a left parenthesis. And I'm going to be asked for how many rows do I wish to sequence? Well, I can see down to about 30 down here, so I'm just going to type in 30. Close my parenthesis and hit enter. And now I can see that I have 1 to 30 all the way down here. But here's something that's really cool. Now if I highlight snake and make my argument back, no, a snake is not a pet, and I can right click and go to delete, I can now see that this has been renumbered. But then finally I give in and I'm like, fine, you snake loving people can have snake as a pet. And I right click and I go to insert. I can see that the 5 has been inserted back in, and I've retained my numbering. So sequence is just a really good way to keep your numbering system intact. But a vertical column is not the only way you can use the sequence function. Let's go over here to D2. If I type in equals sequence and a left parenthesis, I can see that I have several arguments down here. Let's go over what each one of these arguments are. The first one you know is how many rows I'm going to go down. So in this case, let's just say I'm going to go down 5 rows. And if I type a comma, my next argument is columns. So let's just put 4 columns in here and close the parentheses and hit enter. Now I can see that I have a sequence, but instead of it just going straight down, it's going across the number of columns right here, the 4, and it's going down 5, and it's going right to left. Now if I go in there and I type the word transpose with a parenthesis and another parenthesis on this side and hit enter, I can now see that my numbers are going down, but this time it's going to be the opposite. I'm going to go down 4 rows and over 5 columns because I've transposed this. Now I'm going to delete that and show you sequence again. So let's go back to equals sequence with a left parenthesis. And let's go back to our 5 rows and our 4 columns. Now I can have a start number. Let's say I don't want to start with number 1. Let's say I want to start with number 9. And I hit enter. I can now see I'm getting a sequential order, but it's starting with the number 9. Finally, if I delete this and I type equals sequence, again, 5 rows, 4 columns. Let's start with 10. And now this final argument is a step. Notice before that my numbers were incrementing by 1, but let's say I'd like them to increment by 2, starting with the number 10. I bet you can guess what's going to happen. If I hit enter, I can now see that I'm counting by 2s, 10, 12, 14, 16. I'm going in rows and columns, and I have my start number and my step. So as you can see, the sequence function takes one argument that's necessary, which is your number of rows, and then it takes a few optional arguments, including the number of columns, the number that you want to start with, and the number that you want to increment by. So hopefully that gives you a quick introduction to the sequence function, and I hope that you can find a lot of uses for this in your future spreadsheets. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.